'Tis the season for skateboards, skates, scooters, and bikes. But all those wheels are sending nearly 50 kids an hour to the ER, the most common injuries, broken bones and abrasions. But 11% involve serious head injuries, concussions, and skull fractures. Jaden Rivera was 10 years old when he suffered a skull fracture after falling off his bike without a helmet. 3 days later, he was in the ER, lethargic and vomiting.
When I saw the CT scans, I saw the look in the doctor's eye that this was serious. He said we have to get him into surgery now before he dies.
Jaden was bleeding into his brain.
Fractures to their skull. And
Children's National Hospital ER Chief Rob Freistadt says kids' skulls are thinner and more vulnerable.
And so any injury that occurs at that point may damage parts of the brain that have not yet developed and prevent them from developing properly.
It could be permanent.
Absolutely. Lifelong.
But surprisingly, a new study finds 40% of parents surveyed say their kids don't always wear a helmet. Meanwhile, as scooter-related injuries have jumped 40% in 10 years, fewer than 20% of parents say their kids are wearing knee, elbow, or wrist pads. Doctors say everyone, especially kids, should always wear a helmet and protective pads. In Florida, doctors had to use wire mesh to repair Jaden's skull. He survived, but a helmet could have prevented it all. Tom Costello, NBC News, Washington.